So, good morning, dear students. Today we are going to discuss about the topic of series. Okay. So before that we have discussed about this sequence progression and that arithmetic progression and geometric progression. Okay. So today's topic is series. Okay. So addition of terms of the sequence is called series of the sequence. Okay. For example, when the terms are connected by plus or minus sign, then that term is called series. Okay, then that sequence is called series. Now, for example, if I consider this A1, A2, A3, okay, this one is the sequence. No, it is a sequence. It's a sequence. So, if I consider this A1, A2, A3. So this is nothing but a sequence, then the expression A1 plus A2 plus A3. So this one is called series, okay? This is series. This is a series corresponding to this sequence, okay? So addition of terms of the sequence is called the series of a sequence. So if the terms are in the sequence, then addition of this sequence is called the series of the sequence. Okay. So that is when the terms are connected by plus, or you can also use minus in the terms. These are the terms are connected by plus or minus terms, then that term is called series of the sequence. And for example, if you consider this 1 plus 3 plus 5 plus 7. So this one is what? It is a series. Okay. It is a series. So corresponding to the sequence 1, 3, 5, 11, etc. So this is the series and this is the sequence. If I consider this 2, plus 4, plus 6, plus this one 2, 4, if you can consider this 8, so 16 plus 32, so this one is a series corresponding to the sequence 2, 4, 8, 16, 32, etc. So this is the addition of the terms of the sequence, it is called the series of the sequence. So what is the addition of these terms of the sequence? If I consider 1, so 1 by 3, 1 by 9, 1 by 27. So this one is the sequence, no? That is called the sequence. What is the series of that? So addition of the terms, you write in terms of addition. Okay, so this one is called the, so this is called the series. Series of the given sequence, corresponding sequence. Okay, so it means to say that the addition of the terms of the sequence is called the series of the sequence. So this series are usually this often represented in compact form, that is called sigma notation. Series are often represented in in compact form, that is called the sigma notation. This one is like this. So this is called the sigma equal, okay? Sigma notation. This one is the sigma notation. This means means of indicating this summation inward. Okay? This is as means of indicating summation inward. Okay. So summation of this is inward. So this is the Greek word sigma. So series are often represented in compact form, that is sigma notation. So it is as means of indicating the summation inward. Okay. This is about series based on this we will solve the problems. Okay. Next, summation of series by using this sigma n sigma n square and sigma n cube. Okay, next it is the summation of series by using sigma n. Correct as sigma, say sigma. Sigma or summation. Summation I'm indicating this sum is involved over here. Okay, so that is the sigma. Okay, so summation of series by using the next one is summation of series. By using this sigma n square, sigma n. Okay, you should know these formulas. So this we have learned in a mathematical induction. Okay. So what is sigma n? Sigma n is equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3. It is going on up to n, okay? It's n terms, which is equal to n of n plus 1 divided by 2. So you have to know this formula, okay? N of n plus 1 divided by 2. Okay. So now the next one is sigma n square. Square. So 1 square plus 2 square, 3 square, okay, up to n square. So n of n plus 1, so 2n plus 1, okay, 2n plus 1 divided by 6. These are the formulas you need to remember. This sigma n is nothing but 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to n terms, which is equals to n of n plus 1 divided by 2. So sigma n square is equals to 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square up to n square. So n of n plus 1, 2n plus 1 divided by 6. Okay. Similarly, go for this sigma n cube. Okay. Sigma n cube is equals to 1 cube, 2 cube, n cube. Here is n cube. The formula is n square n plus 1 4 square divided by 4. Okay, just remember that. Okay, so what is sigma n? N of n plus 1 divided by 2. N square is n of n plus 1 2 n plus 1 divided by 6. And sigma n cube is n square n plus 1 4 square divided by 4. And you just remember that this value of sigma 1 is equal to n. This also you know, okay? Sigma 1 is equal to n, okay? So based on this, we are going to solve the series problems, okay? So we have learned the sequence in our mind. So this is nothing but addition of the sequence, okay? So addition of the sequence is not series, okay? So after that, use the sigma notation, that is the Greek word. Also, it means that as means of the summation in word, okay? So based on this, we are going to solve the series problem. The problem is like this, okay? Find the sum to n terms of the series. So important, these are all important, okay? Find the, so these series problems are coming in examination for 4 marks, okay? So you have to practice. Find the sum to n terms. So find the sum to n terms of the series. Series whose nth term is n of n plus 2. Okay, this is the problem. You consider first this as a okay, nth term of the series. First, we have to write the nth term of the sequence. That is, this is series to n of n plus 3. You multiply this one, what will happen? So, square n into n is n square. So plus 3 into n is 3. Okay. This is an is equals to n square plus 3n. After that you write sum to n terms is given by sum to n terms is given by, so what is the sum of n terms, that is Sn is equals to, you write like sigma n square plus 3 is a constant here, 3 is a constant, to take it outside, so sigma n, okay. So very very important, writing this is very very important. What is the formula, just to cover the formula, sigma n square, that is n of n plus 1, 2n plus 1 divided by 6. Correct, no? This is the sigma n square, n of n plus 1, 2n plus 1 divided by 6. Okay? 1 plus 3, keep as it is. Sigma n is n of n plus 1 divided by 2. Okay? So, usually students get confusion about this when solving these problems. Don't get confused, okay? So, just do it according to this practically, okay? So, by looking, this one will come to know this 6 came in as 2 into 3, no? This 6. So, what is common here? So, you can just check it n into n plus 1. Divided by 2 is here, you can take the common because here is also the term n of n plus 1 divided by 2 is there. You take n of n plus 1 divided by 2 as common factor. So what are the remaining terms? This is over, n of n plus 1 divided by 2 is over. So the remaining terms are 2n plus 1. So 2 is over, what is here remaining term? 3, no? Because 6 can be written as 2 into 3 plus 3. Okay? You do like this. After this, you know, this is over. Okay, we have done this one. So, which is equals to n of n plus 1 divided by 2. And you know the LCM taking cross multiplication 2n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 into 1 is 2n plus 1. Plus 3 threes are 9, okay? 3 threes are 9 divided by 3 into 1 is 3, okay? So I am simplifying this, okay? Because multiplying this 1 into 2n plus 1, which is equals to 2n plus 1, plus 3 into 3 is 9 divided by 3 into 1 is 3, okay? Which is equals to n now, n plus 1 divided by 2. So 2n, 9 plus 1 is 10, divided by 3, okay. So n of n plus 1 divided by 2. So which is common? So 2 is common, no? So 2 ones are, 2 fives are, n plus 5 divided by 3. So these two will get cancelled, you get Sn is equals to n of n plus 1, n plus 5 divided by 3. So this is the sum to n terms of the series. N of n plus 1, n plus 5 divided by 3. So how to do this one? They are asking to find the sum of the n terms of the series whose nth term is given by an is equals to n of n plus 3. You first multiply this terms n into n is n square plus 3 into n is 3n. After this, you write sum to n terms is given by SN. It is the notation of the sum to n terms of the series. SN is equals to u sigma notation sigma n square plus 3 is constant sigma n. Sigma n square formula is n of n plus 1 to n plus 1 divided by 6. Plus 3 of sigma n is n of n plus 1 divided by 2. So by looking this, we come to know n of n plus 1 divided by 2 is common. We take the less common factor. Remaining term is 2n plus 1 divided by 3 plus 3. So cross multiplication divided by 3. So if you get 2n plus 10, so 2 is common. 2 of n plus 1 divided by 3. So you will get n of n plus 1, n plus 5 divided by 3. Okay. So this is the SN value. So these are little bit lengthy problems. Okay, students don't get confused about this. So this 2n minus 1 whole square. Okay. Consider this as an. Okay, this is an. And again, because in the earlier classes we have discussed sum to n terms of this nth term of the series given by an or small tn or capital Tn like that. Instead of this n, you can write n also, okay? So, 2n minus 1 whole square. How are you going to solve this one? By looking the problem, you will come to see that we have to apply this a minus b whole square formula. What is a minus b whole square formula? That is a square is equal to n square, b square is 1 square, a square plus b square. Minus 2ab, a is 2n, b is 1, okay? So a square plus b square minus 2ab, which is equals to 2 rules of 4n square plus 1 square is 1 minus 2 rules of 4n, okay? This can be written as 4n square plus, this is minus 4n plus 1. This is the nth term. Nth term is 4n square minus 4n plus 1. Okay. So students, don't get confused about this. After this, immediately you have to find out the sum to n terms of the series that is equal to SN. This is the nth term of the series. Now we are going to find the sum to n terms of the series. 4 is constant. Sigma n square minus 4 is constant, sigma n plus sigma 1, okay, because right, if it is 1, sigma 1, okay. So, four, what is sigma n square formula? N of n plus 1, 2n plus 1 divided by 6, okay, minus 4, sigma n. Just now we have learned the summation of series by using the notation sigma n square and sigma n cube, okay? We are using that, okay? N of n plus 1 divided by 2. You know that sigma 1 is equals to n. So after this you take LCM immediately, okay? Don't take comma and all, you get confusion. So what is LCM? That is 6 now. 2 3s are, 2 1s are. This is 2 3s are, okay? 2 3s are. Next, 6 is the LCM. We will get the same terms 4 n of n plus 1, 2 n plus 3 as it is because 6 is LCM. Minus, which is LCM? 6 now. So 2 3s are. 3 in the numerator. 3 4s are 12, okay, 3 4s are 12, that is 12, n of n plus 1. Okay. So, 4 directly because I am taking LCM directly and plus 6n. Okay. Because 6 is LCM 1. Do not take the record multiply. 1 into 6 is n numerator. So, this is not learned. We have learned in earlier classes. In our school days, we have learned. So, 4n of 4. This n plus 1, 2n plus 1. Minus 12 n of n plus 1 plus 6n. 4 divided by is 6. Okay. So after this, you take common. Which is common? What? Which term can you take as common? So shall I write this one? Because it makes space. Okay. So this 6 is for this whole thing, okay? So 6 can be written as 2 into 3, okay? So n is everywhere, okay? Here also n is there, here also in all the three terms n is there. We take n as common divided by 2. 2 is also plenty common. So what will happen now? This is 2 or 3, better, okay? Better take 3, okay? After this, we can take, we can cancel this terms, okay? So, n, I am taking n by 3, okay? So, n by 3, what will happen after taking n by 3? You will get 4n of n plus 1, 2n plus 1. So, 3 is outside. So, 2, no? So, 2 minus 12, this whole divided by 3. This, okay, all divided by this. After that, we will simplify 12 n of n plus 1 plus 6n. Okay, like this. So, I am taking, I am nothing doing here, taking because n is the common factor in the numerator, we take n. Instead of I'm taking 3 outside, what will be remaining? 4n of n plus 1, 2n plus 1, minus 12, n of n plus 1 plus 6n. You multiply this, okay, these terms, this n of n plus 1, n square plus n, okay. So this is n square plus n. Multiply this by 2n plus 1. So n into n is 2n cube, okay? 4n square. N is over. This n we are taking outside. Then, yeah, n is outside. N is common factor. Okay? The remaining term is 6. Correct now? So 4 of n plus 4 of n plus 1, 3 n plus 1, minus 12 of n plus 1 plus 6. Okay? So because I am taking n as the outside, okay? So then we multiply this. Okay? So n of this, we multiply these two terms, that is n plus 1, n plus 1, 2 n plus 1. Take as common, that is 2n square plus 2n. I multiply this 2n into n is 2n square plus 2n into 1 is 2n plus 1 into n is n plus 1 into 1 is 1. So 2n square plus 3n plus 1. So after multiplying, you get n by 3 of this, which is into multiply by 4. Okay. Is equals to 4 to 8 n square plus 4 is 12 n plus 4 is 4, that is 8 n square plus 8 n. Okay. So 12 n plus 4. Okay. So So after this one we are going to get 10 square plus 12 n plus 4, okay? I will just multiply this one, minus 12 n and minus 12 plus 6, okay? All right? Minus 12 n, minus 12 plus 6, okay? It is correct. Next part we have to do is this one. You simplify this one in terms of the n squared. So n divided by 3, 8 n squared. This 12 n and 12 n is going to be cancelled, okay? So this minus 12 plus 6 is minus 6. Minus 6 plus 4 is minus 2, okay? Minus 2. So remaining term 8 n squared minus 2 divided by 2, okay? So after this, n by 3 of which is common here? Yeah, this 2 is common now. So after taking 2 outside, 2 fourths of n squared minus 1 divided by 2. So 2 will get cancelled. We will get n by 3 of this 4 n squared minus 1. So we will get like this. So what is a squared minus b squared formula? You know this a square minus b square is equal to a minus b into a plus b. So a minus b into a plus b, which is equal to a square minus b square. It is of the form a square minus b square, no? You can write 2n whole square, right? Minus 1 square. So it is of the form a square minus b square, which is equal to a minus b into a plus b, which is equal to n by 3 of, which is 2n plus 1 into 2n minus 1. So which is equal to n of 2n plus 1, 2n minus 1, so divided by 3. So this is sum to n terms of the sequence, okay? So this is sum to n terms of the sequence. So students, don't get confused, okay? We can see, you can now apply the different method also, okay? So somehow you are going to get stuck in that, so don't get stuck from there. You just do it simply because we took n as common, no? So don't write n here, n we take it as outside, we took quantity as common. So remaining term is 4 of n plus 1, 2n plus 1 is there. So after this you multiply these terms and multiply that, okay? So you will get, after this these two will get cancelled. So this is nothing but minus 2. So 2 is common, 4 is fine, minus 1. So 2 will get cancelled and we get in terms of 4 n squared minus 1. So this is of a squared minus b squared formula. So apply the formula, okay? You get the result. This is sum to n terms of the series. So similar problems, I'm going to discuss about this, okay? I sent you the notes also, no? Students, it is in PDF form. This course is also over. You just practice, okay? Practice the different problems. Find the sum to n terms of the series. Find the sum to n terms of the series. 1 square, 1 square plus 2 square. So 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square up to n terms. Okay? Up to n terms. So this is nothing but 3n, or you can also use 3n also, okay? 3n. So you know that 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square, what is this? That is sum 2, that is up to n square, it has to be, no? Because this is the formula of sigma n square, no? What is it? Sigma n square, n of n plus 1, 2 n plus 1, divided by 6, okay? Because this is the sigma n square formula. So multiply this one, n of n plus 1, so n square plus n, into multiply this 2n plus 1, you get 2n square plus n square plus n. See, what it means is this n of n plus 1 is n into n is n square plus 1 into n is n. Again, we got one more term, that is 2n plus 1. So 2n into n is 2n cube plus 2n square plus 1 into 10 square is n square plus n. After this, 2n cube plus 3n square plus n. So now it is 2n cube plus 3n square plus n. Okay, by 6, okay? So it is not about upon by 6. 2n cube plus 3n square plus n divided by 6. So now we are going to find something in terms of the series. 2 is constant. Take outside, derive sigma n cube. Again, I am writing the summation of the sums using the sigma n cube of n square like this, okay? Sigma n square plus sigma n, okay? So divided by 6, okay? 2 is outside, sigma n cube. Plus 3 is outside, sigma n square. Plus sigma n divided by 6, okay? So 2, what is sigma n cube? N of n square plus n plus 1 whole square divided by 4, no? Sigma n cube. N square plus n square of n plus 1 whole square divided by 4. So plus 3 of sigma n square is n of n plus 1, 2n plus 1, okay, this divided by 6, okay, to n of n plus 1, 2n plus 1 divided by 6, and sigma n is n of n plus 1 divided by 2. So it is not yet over. Again, the denominator is 1 by 6 is there. You better don't be confused. You put the common here, that is 1 by 6 here. It is a whole thing, no? So you take 1 by 6 as outside, you write this values, okay? Because the 6 is there, don't forget this 6, because you take it outside, then do sigma n cube. That is equal to n square of n plus 1 whole square divided by 4 plus 3 n of n plus 1 to n plus 1 divided by 6 plus sigma n of n plus 1 divided by 2. If you want, you can cancel it out, 2 1s are, 2 2s are, otherwise, then you can apply any method also, 3 1s are, 3 2s are, okay? So after this, what you get? 1 by 6 half. So n square of n plus 1 whole square divided by 2 plus n of n plus 1 into 2n plus 1 divided by 2, because cancel, no? Plus n of n plus 1 divided by 2, okay? So after this, which is common, so everywhere this n of n plus 1 divided by 2 is a take common. So 1 by 6 into n of n plus 1 divided by 2, you take outside. Remaining term is 1 n is there and 1 n plus 1 is there. because there are 2 n square and n plus 1 whole square. There are 2 of this sum. One n of n plus 1 is over 3, which is n of n plus 1 plus. So this is over, you get 2 n plus 1 plus 1. Okay? Because the whole thing is common here, okay? N of n plus 1 divided by 2. So n of n plus 1 plus 3 n plus 1 plus 1. Okay. This is equals to n of n plus 1, 6 2s are 12. So we multiply this one, n into n square plus n plus 2n plus 2. Okay. So n of n plus 1 divided by 12. So n square plus 3n plus 2. So this is the quadratic equation, right? So apply the quadratic equation, n of n plus 1 divided by 12. So what is this equation? N square, suitable factor is 2n plus n plus 2. Okay. So this is n of n plus 1 divided by 12 of this sum. N is common, n plus 2. 1 is common, n plus 2. Okay. So after this you will get so n plus 2 and n plus 1, which is equals to n of n plus 1. Here 1 n plus 1 is there, this 1 n plus 1. N plus 1 whole square into n plus 2 divided by 12. Okay, this is 1, this is n of no. This is n of R. Don't get confused about this. This is R. So n of n plus 1. Why it is n plus 1 whole square here? 1 n plus 1 is there. And after this you will get n plus 1. N plus 1 into n plus 1 is n plus 1 whole square. N plus 1 whole square into n plus 2 divided by 12. Okay. So this is the answer for this. So how do we get this one? So first we have to write 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square is the limit of sigma n square. Now what is sigma n square? That is equals to n of n plus 1 to n plus 1 divided by 6. So multiply the terms and get 2n cube plus 3n square plus n divided by 6. So 2 is constant, sigma n cube plus 3 is constant, sigma n square plus sigma n whole divided by 6 is there, okay? Don't get confused. 6 is there, okay? Here also we will get it in constants divided by upon. So this also we get like this. So better 1 by 6 you take outside. So remaining terms, n cube formula is this, n square is this, and n is n of n plus 1 divided by 2. So you take 1 by 6 is there, no? After that you simplify this. So 3 1s are 3, 2s are 2, 1s are 2, 2s are. So n of n plus 1 divided by 2 is common. You take the less common, you write the remaining terms, okay? After that you get it in quadratic equation. You get it in quadratic equation. Simplify the quadratic equation. You will get n plus 2 into n plus 1, but 1 more n plus 1 is here, n plus 1 into n plus 1 is n plus 1 whole square, okay? So n of n plus 1 whole square, n plus 2 divided by 12 is the answer, okay? So this is a little bit lengthier, and there are methods to solve this one. Choose the suitable method, okay? Correct method, intermediate method. So by taking LCM or you can take the common factor, by that time you have to be very careful.
So this summation of the finite series now, we have completing almost all the problems which are there in summation of this series. And before that we have solved this arithmetic progression, arithmetic mean, relationship between arithmetic mean and geometric mean. After that geometric progression. So these are all the important topics, okay. So it is important for your examination point of view and also for your higher studies also. Okay, you should know all these things, okay. So next example is find the sum to n terms of the series. So find the sum to n terms of the series. Three into 1 square, 5 into 2 square, 7 into 3 square, etc. So this is the another type of series problem. Okay, here they are not given the value of n. We have to find out the nth term first, then we have to find out sum to n terms of the series. How to find out the nth term of the series? So here it is in this progression now, AP, arithmetic progression. So A is equals to nth term of 3, 5, 7. So which are in GP, okay? This is which are in AP, okay? Not in GP, into this 1, 2, 3, up to this square, okay? So we can write like this, you know, arithmetic progression formula, you know, this nth term, finding nth term, a plus n minus 1 into b. So a is the first term, and b is the common difference. 5 minus 3 is equals to 2. So 3 plus 2n minus 2, so it is equals to 2n plus 1, you get 2n plus 1. For this nth term, no, they are not given the nth term directly here. So we need to find out the nth term first, okay? So what is the nth term? This is in progression, it is arithmetic progression. Okay, so that is 3, 5, 7. So here we get this A is the first term, and n minus 1, B is here also 1, n minus 1. Of 1 plus n minus 1, you will get n. Okay? A square is there, you put square. So 2n plus 1 into n square. So this is very careful. Okay? So after this, you multiply 2n into n square is 2n cube plus n square. N, 2n into n square is 2n cube plus n square. For this, we have to find out sum to n terms of the series. Okay? Sum to n terms of the series. For this, so how to find this sum to n terms of the series? Now it is, this is an, now it is sn. Sn is equals to 2 sigma n cube plus sigma n square. So 2 sigma n cube is n square, n plus 1 whole square divided by 4. No? Sigma n square is n of n plus 1, 2n plus 1 divided by 6. So you should know the sigma n square and sigma n cube formula, okay? Just this cancel the 7 times n square of n plus 1 whole square divided by 2 plus n of n plus 1 2 n plus 1 divided by 6. So which is common? N of n plus 1 divided by 2 is common. Now by reading the problem only will come to know which is common. So n of n plus 1 divided by 2 is here. This there, no? You can take it as outside. Remaining term is n of n plus 1 plus this 2n plus 1. So 6 can be as 2 into 3. Okay, 2 into 3. So divided by 3. Okay. N of n plus 1 plus 2n plus 1 divided by 3. So after that, you take LCM. So how to take LCM of this? So n of n plus 1 divided by 2. So cross multiply 3n of n plus 1 plus 2n plus 1 divided by 3. Okay. You multiply the factors of this multiply the terms. So n square. You multiply that if you want to know 3n will be at least 3n square. Plus 3n, okay? So 3nl, 3n square plus 3n plus 2n plus 1. So which is equals to n of n plus 1 divided by 2, 3n square plus 5n plus 1. So divided by 2. So therefore, n of n plus 1. So 3n square plus 5n plus 1 divided by 2. So this is the sum to n terms of the sequence. So here 2 into 3 is here now. You multiply here this is 3, so which is equals to 6. So this is the sum to n terms of the sequence. Okay. So students, it is about this. Series problems, okay? So first we have to write in terms of sigma, n cube, n square, n, and after that we substitute, okay? So you should know the sigma n cube formula, sigma n square formula, sigma n formula. You know this sigma n, this is sigma, the value sigma 1 is equals to n. You should also know that, okay? After that, we need to be simplified. So, by usually you will get n of n plus 1 divided by 2, you will get a common factor. So, after this, we take that common factor outside, write the remaining terms properly, don't skip any steps, okay? But we have to get this final answer as like this. So, if it is correct, then only you will get the answer. So, try to get full 4 marks for this, okay? And for this, you need practice, okay? It's practice, then you will get. So, in similar problems, next class we are going to get, okay? So, series problems. So, after that, it is the chapter is going to be complete, okay? So, you just practice the problems.